not to be scared. I managed to, play dead. Lay there as though I was dead while she was doing whatever she was doing in the room. I was waiting for her to leave. And she didn't leave. And she went to another part, and there's another door. And she was, I could hear the TV, and she was, watching TV or something, and the commercials came on, and I was convinced that, when she had the commercials, that she was going to take a break from her show and come back and finish me off or check and see if I was dead or something already. So I took my chance. I got up. I went to where the washroom was. And I started looking for the escape route. I got confused. I think it was part of another dream that I had had, where we were in a house that had certain escape route built. And one of the entry points was the washroom. And you could drop through this escape route, like a big, long, huge tube kind of thing. You have to get in, and the access to the bathroom was through a panel in the wall. And you could basically drop through to another part of the house and without her seeing me and go from there. I could see her. She was coming, and I couldn't find this escape route. So I took off for the door. And she started chasing me. And I could see she had the pick in her hand. And I hit the hallway. And all of a sudden it was a hallway. it's a dream. Anything can happen. So it was a hallway, and I'm running down the hallway, and the first thing I do when the door flies open and I take off down the hallway, I see somebody standing in the hallway and looks like they're waiting for an elevator. And I just screamed. I said, "Call 911. Call 911. She's going to kill me. She's going to kill me. Call 911. And the woman that saw me, she was halfway down the hall, so, she had time to flip open her phone and call 911 before the woman reached her. All I remember after that is that, I don't know if I must have passed out or something, all I remember is that all three of us were, headed for the hospital. When we got to the lobby, and I remember asking my two friends if we were gonna be taking the ambulance to the hospital. The other man that I had been with, and his mother. And the man was there, and somehow, we were police officers all of a sudden or something, but we had them handcuffed to us so that they wouldn't get away. So we each had two of us had prisoners, but one guy didn't have his handcuffs on. He was just holding him by the arm, and the guy took off. So I'd take off, he took off from our room, but this is one of those, huge washrooms, huge, like one that you'd find at a swimming pool or something. It's got like two really long hallways and showers. So I took off through the men's washroom, and the lady that was with me didn't want to go through the men's washroom, and the man that was with me didn't want to go through the men's washroom. I don't know what his problem was. Maybe he was like geared towards the other door, but I don't know. And I said, "Well, forget it." I said, "You're not going, I'm going. I'm going to catch this guy." So I took off through the hallway in the washroom and, managed to trap him and capture him and that. So afterwards, I'm like, I think this, we'd been stabbed in the throat. I don't know what happened. I guess we weren't seriously injured because I remembered a lot of blood, but all of a sudden there was none. And I remember turning to my friend and saying, "I think this qualifies for ambulance trip to the hospital, right? I mean, we're gonna go to the hospital, right?" It was kind of funny that way, but And then the next thing I remember is just sitting at the cafeteria in the lobby, and we're getting ready to eat food. And there's just me and the woman. Everybody else is gone. The man and his mother are in jail, supposedly, and the other man, he was the other guy that I had slept with. He was the guy that I was there with the other woman. And partner in our job or police force or whatever we were doing. He was the one in worse shape. He was the one that was in the ambulance, went to the hospital. He almost died. But that's my dream. I woke up. First thing I did was check my throat. And I had to keep checking my throat for the first half hour that I was awake. Make sure it was still there or something. I don't know, but... Okay. I'm almost calm now. I'm almost done being paranoid, too. What a crazy dream. I don't get them as often as I used to, but when I do, they literally scare me right out of my skin. It takes me forever to calm down from them. I don't know if anybody's ever had these kind of dreams, but that's the way they work. It's a fear. And when I woke up, I was so scared, the only thing I could do was pray. I remembered in my dream, when I was laying there waiting to die on the bed, some of the only things I could do was pray, because it was one thing that she couldn't hear. She couldn't control it, and she couldn't stop it. And if anybody could save me or do anything about it, it was God. So I was praying for all I was worth. And I was very thankful by the end of that he had heard my prayer. But, yeah, so that's... I don't know. That must be a combination of a whole bunch of things in that dream to cause me to have that kind of a whacked out dream. But, I'm not going to get into the kind of things that probably are involved in that, but anyway, that's my dream, and I've been rambling now for 18 minutes, so I'm going to shut up. Hope you all have a good night, and I will see you tomorrow.